Hello, Mary Sybold. From me, Merry Christmas. Well, I'm a bit discombobulated, to tell you the truth. I'm all out of bobs. Just now, I went to call on Hugh, a.k.a. Mr. Hefner, or indeed, the Hef. He hadn't been answering my messages and I wanted to find out why. Well, he's dead. It's not impossible that he's spending the year dead for tax reasons, like that bloke did in those space sci-fi novels. But he's not looking good. I mean, look at this hand. It's gone a bit mouldy. Oh, I know. You're judging me for taking his hand. Frankly, this is the only hand I'm likely to get in marriage, seeing as Donald has still not shaken off malaria. Some might say it's a lost cause, but I've met some, and I don't like the cut of his jib. So, I know that you were all agog to find out how Hugh and I knew each other. Not in a biblical sense, let me tell you. I know that's what some of you are thinking, especially you, Jason, because you've got a dirty mind. Now, I was in fact the inspiration for his magazine. Not to mention his original bunny girl. Because, you see, he was a bit stuck on the choice of animal. He had a predilection for mooses. Mooses? Mices? Maybe it's meat. Oh, anyway, the horns got in the way, and not in a good way either. So I suggested something like cute and fluffy and that, and more importantly, something could be got cheaply in Poundland World, because they had a job lot of bunny ears. So off we went. I don't think I'll be going to the funeral. I am spending the year away from the tax inspectors because I'm avoiding my tax. And there's bound to be loads of them there. Instead, I shall just cherish the memory of Hugh and remember him with this. Because bunnies like carrots. Stop it, you dirty beasts. Bye-bye.